everyone, my name is Leah and welcome to my tech space. In this tutorial series, we'll start off by going over the basic parts of Vex Robotics. These parts are important to know the names of so that you know what other people are talking about, and you'll sound extra smart if you use them when you're talking to other people. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so this is a high strain shaft, and this is a low strain shaft. This is a shaft collar for a high strain shaft, and this is a shaft collar for a low strain shaft. So what a shaft collar basically does is that when it's tight, it can be tightened around a shaft, and when it's tightened, it clamps the shaft so that when it's like tilted anyway, anything that's over here, and if it's put upwards, it won't fall through. So that is shaft collars and on shafts. Okay, so these are bolts and these are nuts. So as you can see, there's many different sizes of bolts that you can get, and there are two different kinds of nuts that you can get. So this is a regular nut, and this is a locking nut. So what the locking nut does is that it has this rubber inside to it, so when put through, when a bolt's put through it and screwed on, it will only stop up to there, and you will need a screwdriver and a wrench to actually push it through for the rest. And for the bolts, as you can see here, these two have like a bluish ring around them, which means that they have Loctite around them, so they have a really strong hold. So the locking nut and the bolt with Loctite give a really strong hold. And yeah, that is bolts and nuts. Okay, so these are spacers and these are standoffs. So the spacers are basically just little things put on shafts and bolts that give that set amount of certain space. So this one is for a low strain shaft, and then this one is for a high strain shaft. And there's many different sizes of spacers that you can get and put set amount of space. Whereas the standoffs, they also set amount of space, but they're tapped, which means that they have threads going through them. So these ones are tapped completely through, whereas this one is not. So this one can go straight through a bolt, or this one would have to have two bolts going in between here. So that is the difference between spacers and standoffs. Okay, so these are bearings and these are lock bars. So there's many different types of bearings you can get, and you can choose them based on your preference for the certain type of design. And this one is for a high strength shaft, and these three are for a low strength shaft to go through them. So what a bearing does is basically it just has it's a place for the shaft to circle freely within it. And so in this hole, the shaft would go in here and it would just spin freely. Whereas a lock bar, this is for a low strain, these two are both for low strain shafts, and the shaft would go in through here and it wouldn't be able to move freely. So whatever, when it spins, whatever is bolted onto these lock bars would move with the shaft. So that's the difference between bearings and lock bars. Okay, so now how the robot moves. So there are many different types of wheels you can get, and there are even more than these that I'm just going to show you. But the main ones are that this is an omni wheel. So it basically means that it has like rollers on them, which means it has the ability to move side to side with ease. This one is just a regular wheel. So it has trouble moving from side to side, but it has great traction. And this one is an intake roller, which means that it has it's a smaller wheel, and it has flexible panels on the wheel, so that when dealing with like any sort of object with like intake to the robot, it'll be able to grab it and pull it into the robot. So that is the difference between omni wheels, regular wheels, and intake wheels. Okay, so this is gears, this is sprockets, this is a tank tread, and this is a chain. So there are many different sizes of gears and sprockets, and what gears do is that it basically just, it's designed to move another gear. So it fits into here, and while this one is spinning, it spins another gear. Whereas a sprocket is designed to pull another sprocket. So as this one is spinning, it'll, whatever is attached to the other sprocket, it'll move it. So for example, this chain could be attached to one sprocket and then pulled by another sprocket, like so. A tank tread is used in another form of wheels, and they are used when you don't want to have, you want to have a continuous movement of your wheels. So that's gears, sprockets, tank treads, and chains. Okay, so these are structure pieces. They are used to build the majority of the robot, like the actual structure that people see. So there are many different types of structure pieces that you could use. Like, for example, this is a flat piece. This is a C-channel. And this is an angle piece. And this is an even smaller angle piece. There are these different angle pieces that you could use that connect through with bolts. And they create different types, different angles that you could use. So if attached to here, it could create a different angle like that. They're just connector pieces, so in case you want to add more onto it. But these, you could choose whatever piece of material that you want to build based on your design. So this is the structure of the robot. Okay guys, that's it for today. I hope you guys liked this video. Please tell me in the comments whether you thought this video was like too fast, too slow, too complicated, too simple. Just tell me how you felt about it, just so I can improve it for future tutorials. And please be sure to like, subscribe, and I'll catch you guys next time. Bye!